Guys, we got makeup on. I wore earrings. I'm wearing mascara. Also, guys, I'm like fully color coordinated with my background, which is kind of cool. I'm gonna get nice and comfortable. It is Thanksgiving here. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. This is my favorite holiday of all time. And the last video I shot in this series was how I broke into Bollywood. And there were some comments like, well, Shefani, when you figure this whole thing out, why the hell did you decide to leave? And that's what this video is gonna be all about, is the real reason why I left Bollywood. I think there are a lot of preconceived notions of like, oh, maybe this happened, or you weren't successful, or X, Y, and Z. I'm gonna backstory a little bit. When I moved to Mumbai, I genuinely thought there was a 50% chance that I might live here the rest of my life. I didn't go in thinking that, oh, it's just gonna be a 1 year stint or 5 year stint or whatever. I thought there might be a chance that I love it, I kill it in my career, I'm gonna live there, settle there, marry a boy in Bombay, and like, that's gonna be my life. In Bombay, I was truly living my dream, right? I was interviewing Bollywood celebrities, I was modeling, I was earning money, I was like connecting with the coolest of people, networking. But when I came back to the US, when I visited 6 months later, we always ask these questions, like in our family, and we all kind of go around the table and answer. And someone asked me, what has been your favorite memory of 2018 so far? And my answer wasn't the interview with Salman Khan. It wasn't like, oh, I did this modeling shoot. It wasn't, oh, I earned X amount of money for this campaign. My favorite memory is right now, when all my favorite people are all under one roof. Like, we itch for those 4 days that we spent together and that camping trip or that like vacation. But why not design a life that incorporates more of those moments together? It sounds really morbid, but I can bank on max to max 25 years left with my parents. I can guarantee that. Also, it's not a guarantee. And if someone tells you, you only have 5 years left, 10 years left, 20 years left to build memories with people that you love, that's when it hits. I think there's a certain fear when people pass away that, shit, I wish I had made that call. I wish I had made that trip. I wish I had spent that time with them. I wish I had done this. I don't want to wake up and have that regret thinking, man, I wish I would have been closer to my parents. I wish I would have been able to fly over and be there for those moments. I wish my kids could have built a better relationship with their future mama, like Shreyans' family. I think it's so rare to have the relationships that I do with my parents that I feel like I'd be silly or stupid to not make the most of it, you know? I want to build a life that I'm not just seeing my parents once or twice a year. And the reality would be that if I lived in Mumbai, my kids would probably see my brother's kids, which Shreyans would never live in Bombay, maybe once, maybe twice a year. So that happened. I left Cleveland kind of with that feeling, thinking I need to move back to the US at some point. Then I feel like this also just, I think it's serendipity to some extent. On my flight back to India, it was New York to Paris, Paris to India. And on that flight from New York to Paris, I was sitting next to this woman who was in her 60s. She was originally from Paris and lives in the New York, New Jersey area. And I was asking her, how was your Thanksgiving? She was asking about mine. And she said, I have 4 kids, and 3 of my kids and their grandkids are now in this New York, New Jersey area. But she's like, I have 1 daughter who's in Texas, and the daughter, son-in-law, and her kids were not able to attend their Thanksgiving this year. The grandkids that all live in New York, New Jersey, they've all grown up together. They can speak in French. They're able to spend time with them. They have a close relationship. But her daughter that's in Texas, she's like, she's totally just away from the family. She's like, Mom, I want my kids to speak in French, but you know, the grandparent, meaning the lady, was telling me, she's like, am I supposed to teach them French over FaceTime? It's not gonna happen. That's not to say that you can't build a close relationship with someone that's like far away. I have so many relationships, my masis and chachis and like people that I'm still as close to. But there is a difference, because Rosemary, like in every single day, you're not interacting with them. And my priority at 22, 23 then was, I need to figure out a way how the hell I'm gonna pivot and take all this Bollywood entertainment stuff and go back to the US. And yes, does that mean I'm gonna be living in the same city as Shah Rukh Khan? No. Are you gonna experience like killer street food and those experiences? No. But I value those memories with my family over that. I mean, I'll say it on camera because I hope it comes true. One of my biggest dreams is that my entire family, me, Shreyans, Sham, my parents, my in-laws, Shreyans is like future wife and their family, all live together in the same state, same city, maybe even like same neighborhood. But we just get to like grow together. I think there are a lot of people that will say, oh, Shani, well, you're in your 20s. This is not the time to be like thinking about family. It's the time to be going out and living in the big city and doing your thing. And that's absolutely fine. And I did my thing for 2 years in Bombay, and it wasn't like I didn't experience that. If that's what you prioritize, like, that's absolutely fine. This isn't for everyone. But I also think that you don't have to follow a conventional path and do that just because every single other person is doing that. So many times we just follow a path to follow a path, and we really don't think about why are we doing that, and like, is there a way to question or challenge or change that? There's a lot more that I could probably say, but I'm just gonna leave you guys with that. So thank you so much. Until next time, bye.